Hi guys, welcome back to Ajivat channel. So in this video, we will be dealing with the equine intestinal nematode, that is Par Ascaris picorum. So this is a serious issue in the north region of India because it is a very common nematode found in the horses and the camels in the northeast places. So the death is very common after 20 to 23 days. So since anemia is a very big factor here, so death is very common. So we can go to the video. So if you haven't subscribed our channel yet, feel free to subscribe and hit the bell button for more updates. So Par Ascaris species, they are actually belonging to the Ascarida order, that is class Acerandia. So if you are not familiar with the order, the family, the species and all, you can see my video on the taxonomy of Ascarida and all. So I'll give the link in the description box. So the species is Par Ascaris icorum, and the synonym is Ascaris icorum and Ascaris megacephala, that is megacephala. Cephala region is very big. So the host, that is the definitive host, is horse, donkey and zebra, and they are found mainly in the small intestine region. So they will be biting with the hook and suckers and all, they will be biting to the mucosa and all, they will be sucking blood, proteins and all, they will be living there. So Par Ascaris icorum. So this is actually the adult worms in the small intestine. You can see the adult worms. They are very large, big worms. So they are very large ascarid parasites of horse. They can up to be 2 feet long, and they have large distinctive lips. And the males have two long spicules. So these are the morphological and descriptions and all. So life cycle is direct. There is no intermediate host. And the migratory route involves hepatopulmonary route. So this is a very big problem in case of young foals, because this can produce verminous pneumonia. So eggs with L2 infective by 10 to 14 days. So eggs with L2 infective larva is the infective stage of this. So what happens after completing the molt in the lungs, the larvae ascends into the expectorant mucus of tracheobronchial tree and by return lumen of the esophagus and stomach. So you can see a video of Par Ascaris icorum. So this is a very important video of Par Ascaris icorum. This is actually doing a postmortem of the intestine. So you can see, this intestine is completely loaded by Par Ascaris icorum worms. You can see thousands and thousands of adult worms are there. So this will lead to colic actually. They will be obstructing the intestine. And what happens? The intestinal flora diminishes. What happens? Truck will be there. And what happens? There will be colic and completely pressure on the intestine and all. So what happens? Ultimately, it dies. So due to the pulmonary problems, or to the obstruction and due to the digestive problem, they will get anemic and they will be emaciated and soon they will die. So this is actually happening in case of Par Ascaris icorum. So you can see completely thousands and thousands of worms are there. So the clinical signs, foals 3 to 9 months of age especially suffer from this parasite and they will be having death shore. So flatulence and pod-bellied appearance is the very common. So bowel movement will be happening a problem, and there is a generalized peritonitis due to the obstruction of the intestine. So you can see this is actually the pod-bellied appearance. So this is actually the stages in foal, and eggs will be passed. So what happens? Eggs are passed in the feces. Infective second stage larva develop within the egg. So what happens? While grazing, they ingest infective eggs. Larval stages migrate via small intestine to the liver and then to lungs. Then larvae will return to small intestine via cavae and swallowing. And they'll be producing eggs and all. So this is the Par Ascaris icorum egg in fecal flotation method. You can see the egg inside with L2 larva. So this is the comparison of strong helix and Par Ascaris icorum. So the treatment is actually through piperazine compound. Piperazine is the best compound for treatment. And fenbendazole, pyrantel, moxidectin, etc. So pyrantel tartarate is used as a feed additive. It's not addictive, it's additive. Prevents infection in case of horses. So in young foals, we'll be giving the pyrantel tartarate as a feed additive so that it can control the infection and prevent the infection. So control is actually, stable should be cleaned properly, proper disposal of the manure. So brood mare should be treated for Ascaris before foaling. Yeah. So thank you guys.